This is Marsh Harbor, and an area that has the worst destruction from a hurricane that I've ever seen. This area was known as the Mud, once a community of Haitians, 300 homes that were wiped off the map by wind and storm surge. Huge shipping containers from the port brought in by the waves washed over the homes like boulders down a hill.
Take a look at this. You're looking at remnants of people's lives, a worker's pants, his tools scattered all around us, and there is just nowhere for them to live now.
As I drove around the destruction on the island, I came upon a family of Haitians who had been forced to move to this shell of a building when their home was wiped out by Dorian.
If I was stay home, I'd be here talking to you now.
Charity Alado and his family are now just barely hanging on.
Boy, life hard. You don't have no place to live.
He's angry because Alado says the Bahamian government has all but forgotten the Haitian community of Marsh Harbor. The Haitians are the working class here. They toil as laborers and workers for tourist destinations. Many Haitians had little before the hurricane. They have even less now.
I was a Haitian Bahamian, and I ain't seen no one help me yet.
As Dorian reached its height, people from the Haitian community of the Mud and the Peas left their homes that were collapsing around them. They came to this building, a church made of reinforced concrete, because they thought this building would be safe. Unfortunately, the roof came down and people lost their lives here.
For the storm, I've been by the church, and where I was, the water still come up.
A once thriving downtown Marsh Harbor is now empty. Huge boats have been tossed onto city streets. The buildings that remain are vacant, and all businesses here are closed. And it struck me that the people I had just met have no work, no place to live, and the foundations of their homes are all that remain, meaning they will now have to rebuild their lives from the ground up.
The people who were living here have obviously been displaced. There's simply no place left to live. Many have gone to Nassau, and they're still hoping for help. In the Bahamas, I'm Jeff Patterson.